Good morning, students. Let's start our new chapter of Standard 9th, Energy Flow in an Ecosystem. I hope you have cope up with this new learning style. Nowadays, education for you is at the tip of your fingers, as you don't have to pack your bags. You just need to charge your phone or laptop and watch the videos shared by your teachers. But what if there is a power cut and your mobile battery is running low? It will get turned off because mobile runs on energy which it receives from electricity. If these non-living organisms need energy, then of course, living things also need some energy to survive. Let's understand where does this energy come from in this chapter. We have already learned that our ecosystem is made up of biotic and abiotic factors, and all the living organisms are dependent on one another for their food. According to their mode of nutrition, they are classified as producers, consumers, saprophytes, and decomposers. Consider the various trophic levels of the ecosystem around you. Primary consumers, herbivores, they are directly dependent on autotrophs. Examples: squirrel, elephant, rabbit, deer, etc. Secondary consumers, carnivores. These consumers use herbivores as their food. Example: owl, fox, snake, spider, etc. Apex or top consumers. These consumers use herbivores and carnivores as their food. No other animals feed on the top consumers. Example: tiger, lion, crocodile, wolf, etc. Mixed consumers. These feed on herbivores and carnivores. Example: human, dog, hen, ostrich, etc. Now observe the interaction between each component in this animation. You must have observed that each component was food for the other. This interaction goes continuously. So, food chain can be defined as a definite sequence in the interaction between producers, consumers, and saprophytes. This is just one example of food chain. An ecosystem consists of many such food chains which are interconnected at various levels, forming an intricate web instead of linear chain. Let's understand how. Look at this picture. This is very complex. Look at the rabbit. It can be prey for secondary as well as top consumers. Same way, plants can be eaten by elephant or by deer. This kind of complex food chain, which include more than one chain, are called food web, as they are very interconnected like spider web. Now tell me, what will happen if the number of organisms at a level rises or decreases suddenly? For instance, if the number of snakes are reduced, it will ultimately affect the number of eagles, which are directly dependent on them for food. And this will create an imbalance in the ecosystem. Therefore, it is necessary to maintain balance in a food web. As we see, food web consists of more than one food chain, and food chain consists of more than one level. Each level in the food chain is called trophic level. If all trophic levels are arranged from producer to the omnivores, it creates an illusion of pyramid. At the bottom of this pyramid are producers. Above them are herbivores as first trophic level. Moving Moving up in the pyramid, we have carnivores as second trophic level. And on the top of all are omnivores as third trophic level. Do you know who introduced the concept of pyramid? A British scientist, Charles Elton, first proposed the concept of ecological pyramid in 1927. The amount of energy and number of organisms gradually decreases from producer at the lowest level to the top consumers at the highest level. As organisms at each trophic levels fulfill their energy requirement from the organisms of lower trophic level. On average, only 10% of energy is transferred from one trophic level to another, while the rest is used for metabolic activities of individuals, or it's lost as heat energy. This pattern of energy exchange in the ecosystem is called pyramid of energy. After the death of apex consumer, their energy becomes available to the decomposers. Decomposers convert them into simple carbon compound, which easily mixes with air, water and soil, from where they are again absorbed by plants and incorporated into the food chain. Till now, we have seen the energy is transferred from producer to the top consumers. But from where does producer get energy? The answer is sun. The sun is most important source of energy in an ecosystem. The producers, means the green plants of the ecosystem, store some of the solar energy in the form of food. Before reaching the decomposers, this energy is passed on from one trophic level to the next. Decomposer dissipates some amount of energy in the form of heat. However, no part of energy ever returns to the sun. Hence, such passage of energy is referred to as one-way transport. With this, we have learned about the food chain, food web, and pyramid of energy. There is a lot more to explore. I will see you soon with the next part of this chapter. Till then, take care of yourself, eat healthy, and restore your energy. Thank you.